Y'all were called to assist in emergency disaster operations.
When disaster strikes,
this is the particular area that we're dealing with.
Game wardens from all across Texas respond to the emergency.
A crash near Fort Hood area.
150 Cessna.
A terrorism act.
An organized mass attack on U.S. assets.
Fortunately, this event is only a test.
It's got this strontium 90 in it.
This drill, simulating a plane crash and terrorist attack, will help wardens respond to all disasters by training them in the very latest mapping and global positioning technology.
Be careful out there. We don't want anybody hurt.
Now, we should have a grid once you get out there and get positioned. And so if you guys kind of want to move it over a little bit.
GPS technology can be used for just about every facet of our business. So we felt like it was time that we went ahead and got more game wardens to experience it in a drill before they really have to use it.
It's a technology useful to many, but it can be vital to those doing rescue and recovery work.
You're supposed to be in this grid right here.
Right.
Using advanced GPS units, response teams can be sure that search areas or grids are covered completely.
That's where we are.
It's a way of keeping track of where you're assigned to go and where you've been, so you can do a more systematic search.
It may sound simple, but it requires some practice.
Okay.
It's going to be a brand new experience for them.
Now we need to go this way.
It's a little scary.
What, do we just get out and start walking?
We'll get you in the right vicinity.
They're trying some new units that they've never used before.
But it.
You just won't let me do it.
It's a little troublesome at first.
This one's kind of got us confused.
But once you get to know the equipment, it's easier.
I got a ways to go. But it is a learning experience.
The learning experience includes not just GPS, but also GIS, or Geographic Information System.
GIS is a way of putting data that we have collected into a visual form that we can make sense of. A lot of people think of it as computer mapping. It allows us to overlay maps where you can look at how things relate to each other, see if there are correlations. GPS and GIS work real closely together.
Because computers are involved, there are a few bugs to work out.
That didn't look like what we want.
I don't know, man.
It's taken some getting used to.
We got ourselves a problem with that image there.
But we've had plenty of help to figure it out.
What's that?
GIS and GPS technology can't replace the legwork.
You're getting pretty far down there.
But they can help search teams work more efficiently.
Yes, some debris right there.
We found a couple pieces of plastic from the airplane, and we're going to be marking them with the Trimble unit here.
Piece by piece, the mock debris is pinpointed electronically and flagged for retrieval.
Yeah. We're getting there.
Back at the command center, this data begins to yield maps rich with information that would be vital to hazmat crews or federal investigators.
Well, I see a lot of potential for this technology.
So much data to collect.
D9.
As you find all of that and you can map it out, you can kind of lay out a pattern of what took place. And that's important.
I wish we'd had this training in this technology when the shuttle came apart.
The red dot.
When they had the shuttle event happen in East Texas,
or confirmed pieces.
There was a lot of game wardens that participated in that.
It's like one piece of tile.
Collecting that debris and using some of this type of equipment.
Locations.
They know landowners, knew those woods, and how to get into them.
You stand under it and mark it.
Also, game wardens, in the event that something does happen, we are usually the people in a rural area that have the equipment that can get there. Four-wheel drives, ATVs, boats. So it makes sense that we would probably be the first ones on the scene, and this technology would help us a long way as far as being able to use our manpower and our equipment in these type of emergencies. Some teams go in by air, by helicopter, some by ATV, and begin working foot search grids. They've done a good job of covering the area and doing the searches. They're picking up all the debris points. So we're finding what we need to find out in the field.
Aha, we have something.
Coordinating searches with this new technology is going well.
A blue briefcase.
Accident debris is located, which in a real scenario might determine the cause of an accident or unravel a terrorist plot.
Go ahead, team Nora.
located a possible explosive ordnance device.
But the biggest success of today's drill may be in how different groups are coming together and coordinating their response.
Uncovered some hazmat material.
They're going to send Department of Defense to see how hazardous it is.
The drill is amazing how many agencies, to get us all together, it would have to happen this way. The knowledge from one group can save all the other groups.
A lot of times one agency may not have exactly what they need, but another one might, so you mingle together and you can get it all done.
It's PC-028, ended at 1048.
I think this training will really be useful in our crime scenes and investigations. Lost child, anyone that's missing, basically anything that we're searching for, we can use this training.
60 feet this way and goes back.
As teams wrap up a long day of searching,
almost there,
they're still finding ways that GIS and GPS will help them in the future.
It's taking some time, but some of this technology is amazing.
This technology makes our work more efficient, whether it's working a wildlife crime or whether it's conducting search and rescue.
So it's doing circles.
The drill was a big success.
Okay, we're here, it's working now.
And as Texas game wardens know,
come look at the screen.
You can always hope for
the
best.
The exact trail that they walked back and forth through the whole grid.
But you are not truly prepared until you can map out a plan for the worst.
They covered some ground.
We do a lot of training, and certainly you hope you never have to use most of it. But unfortunately, there's times when we use it, and so we want to be prepared in this same situation because it is an important part of Texas Homeland Security. I think that people can realize that they do have people that are concerned about this, especially in the rural areas, not just the urban areas, and that there will be people that can come into those rural areas and help them. Whether it's a Texas Game Warden or many of the other agencies, will all be there working together for the people of the state of Texas.